Hey guys, it's Redbeard here from AudioBiz, and today we're talking about the legendary SM58. In preparation for Shure's SM58 Day coming up on May 8th, I'm going to tell you 5 things that you may not know about this legendary microphone. Number 1. The SM in SM58 stands for Studio Microphone. Shure's microphones were a staple in the public address market, but in the 60s, Shure saw a potential for growth in broadcast and television market, so they developed the SM series of microphones. One unique feature is the paint job. You'll notice it's a non-reflective black and silver coating, which makes it great for on-camera. Number 2. The SM58 almost faced extinction in 1970. There was a single competitor that was so entrenched in the broadcast and studio markets that engineers weren't super excited about the SM series of microphones. Shure had plans to discontinue the series, but their national sales manager had the great idea to introduce the microphones to the live sound engineers in Las Vegas. Shortly thereafter, performers and engineers loved using them, and it became the staple of the live sound market. Number 3. Add a mesh ball grill to an SM57, you've got an SM58. The only difference between an SM57 and a 58 is this ball grill. It acts as a pop filter while using it for close mic'd vocals. If you're ever in a pinch and forgot an SM57 for a show, grab an SM58, take the ball off, you've got a 57. This mic was built to perform. It's virtually indestructible. The ruggedness is amazing. You've probably seen videos online of people using them as hammers, drop tests, all of these different things. Ernie Seeler, the designer of the Unidyne 3 capsule that's in the SM58, did testing by burning it, submerging it, freezing it, all of these things to make this mic as rugged as possible. And these standards are still in place today. It makes this mic virtually indestructible. You buy one, you'll have it for a lifetime. Number 4. This mic will go to 11 or 12. How much SPL can the SM58 handle? At what point is that audio going to distort? The SM series of microphones were designed to handle between 150 and 180 dB SPL. This is equivalent to a rocket ship taking off. So it'll handle anything that you can throw at, including those heavy metal vocals. Number 5. Ernie Seeler, the man behind the development of the SM series of microphones, didn't even like rock and roll. It's kind of ironic that the quiet, soft-spoken man who preferred classical music invented the microphone that became so synonymous with rock and roll. Ernie Seeler once said, "I love classical music, but rock and roll I don't take too seriously." Well, our hat's off to you, Ernie, for making the most rockin' microphone ever.
Excellent!
Thanks for tuning in on 5 things that you might not have known about the SM58. And join AudioBiz on May 8th in celebration of this legendary, iconic microphone. Send us a picture of you using a mic, or send us a short video of what you love about the SM58. Until next time, catch you out there, and stay rockin'.